Okay, let's try this here. I hope this works. If I were to use this tape measure here to measure something, while I'm measuring it, I've got to focus on it. I've got to look at it and pay attention to it. And there might be other things going on around me that are equally important. But while I'm focused on the act of measuring, I have to ignore and not pay attention to those other things. There's an old saying, you improve what you focus on, and you focus on what you measure. There's just way too many software companies that I run into that are focused on the wrong things because they're measuring the wrong things. In this video, I want to show you how you can help your company actually make a lot more money with your software by helping them measure and then build the right things. You know how traditionally software development teams, they're measured on how much it costs to build a product. Since this is the focus, people who are doing the measuring, they're rewarded based on how cheaply they can build the product. But a product being cheap has nothing to do with how successful the product's going to be in the market overall. The success of the product depends on how well was it designed and do customers love that experience. And it depends on whether customers that are using the product are going to pay enough for it for the company to actually profit. This takes the right combination of pricing, service, and everything that goes into making customers actually want to pay for using the software. All of this has a much bigger impact on the overall success of the business than just how much the product costs. To build a great product with a really great experience takes taking the customer's feedback into really strong consideration. All the best software products, think about your Amazon, Facebook, Linux, they all changed significantly in the time between when they were originally designed and when customers finally fully accepted and embraced them. Here's the big problem. If you don't have the money to build what your customers really want, how cheap you can build your ideas that might not include everything they want doesn't matter. Projects that focus on how cheaply the original vision that the leadership came up with for a software product can be made, they don't have any money left over to accommodate the things that customers tell them after they start releasing the software. And so they can never actually fully even satisfy the customer. So the product really makes any money for the company. It's almost like building a cheap factory. You can cut corners and cut costs on the cost of producing that factory, but now if it can't actually produce any products on the assembly line to make money for the company, who cares how cheap you built the factory? When we cut costs building a software product, we're cutting costs on the thing that we're actually putting into the market to generate revenue or solve a problem for us, which is really kind of backwards if you think about it. This is why we all try to be agile, to build a little slice or a little bit of a whole vision for a product and release just that little bit at a time to a customer and be able to change it and adapt it as they give us feedback. And when you're running an agile project, that project is going to produce a product that emerges over time. The features and the design of that software product are not all known up front. So the cost of the initial design of an agile software product has almost nothing to do with the real cost, because there's a ton of changes that are going to have unpredictable costs that have nothing to do with the original design. So you really should just budget your software development projects like Netflix. Decide how many people you can afford over a period of time, let's say a year, and just pay them monthly. The beauty of this is, as things change, which they inevitably will, that's the whole reason we try to be agile. Agile literally means to be able to respond to change. No one has to go get more budget or go get more money because the team's already fully funded when you budget monthly. Every month, the team just does whatever's most valuable. And if they find out something's more difficult than they thought, they just make sure it's built properly for the customer. So let's say your project is budgeted monthly. You can still estimate and track time on an agile project that's budgeted monthly, but it really provides little benefit because building the right thing is more important than building it fast. In fact, if speed is what your team focuses on, that actually can make it harder to build the right thing. First of all, measuring speed costs time and money for the people doing it. Every time we have to estimate, we have to track our time, we have to track the difference between an original estimate and where we are. That isn't free. That takes time, that takes communication, and that all costs hours and real money for the people doing the work. The other thing it creates is a conflict of confidence between two people when one of those measurable numbers changes. Now, two or more people have to get together and they have to discuss and rectify why an estimate was off or how much a change that a customer wants is really going to cost. Measuring how close a team's work is to the original plan in Agile is stupid because an Agile project is going to change. And when it does change, the skill and the creativity of the people doing the work is what's going to determine how successful the company is, not how close people can massage the numbers as things are changing to get them to look like the original plan. So your company should focus instead on measuring whether the product you're producing is actually reaching its business outcomes, not how quickly the team can deliver it. We want to actually achieve growth and financial outcomes for the company because of the software product, not save costs. This all might sound like total common sense to you, but there are many people that cannot live without their estimates and their daily status to track. They have to let go of measuring the wrong thing to let the team adapt and build the right thing. And they have to, unfortunately, be more patient because getting feedback on the financial outcome of work that we do as a team, it takes longer. If we do a release, it could take a couple weeks, a month, several months until enough information is gathered from the customer and the business about how well that feature really fit its goal. And many managers want a number every day they can look to that tells them the project's on track. And having a number that just tells them how much money's been spent doesn't actually tell them that the project's on track. It just says how close to completing what was planned we are. And again, on an Agile project, we're not going to build what's planned. We're going to start with the plan, but we're going to start building it knowing it's going to change. So next time you're deciding whether to estimate costs or measure the velocity of a software development team, I want you to ask yourself, is what I'm measuring really making the business successful? Or is it just giving me another number to track that's actually getting in the way of people doing their best work? How are your software teams being measured? Are they being measured primarily based on cost and predicting the effort, or are they being measured mostly based on business outcomes? Leave me some comments below. If you're new to my YouTube channel, consider subscribing, and you can always listen to these instead as a podcast on Google Play, Stitcher, SoundCloud, or iTunes. You can just search for Healthy Software Developer, and you'll find me there. Until next time, thanks.